What is percentage purity? A seashell is composed largely of calcium carbonate, but not everything inside the seashell is calcium carbonate. Some of it is, and some of it is other chemicals. So if we want to know how pure a certain shell is with regards to calcium carbonate, what we actually want to know is what fraction of that shell is calcium carbonate. What percentage of that shell is calcium carbonate? Here's the formula for percentage purity. The mass of the desired substance, that means the one we're interested in, for example, maybe calcium carbonate, divided by the mass of the entire sample, for example, the mass of the whole shell. This gives us the fraction of the whole shell that just the calcium carbonate part of the shell is. Then we multiply that fraction by 100% to convert the fraction into a percentage. So for the case of shells, that comes to the mass of calcium carbonate that you find in this particular shell divided by the mass of the whole shell converted to a percentage. So let's take a very easy example to start with. Shell 1 has a mass of 0.5 grams. So the whole shell has a mass, when you put it on a scale, of 0.5 grams. 0.4 grams of this is calcium carbonate. And the remainder, which is 0.1 gram, of course, is some other stuff, which we could call impurities. So what we're asked to find out is the percent of the whole shell that is calcium carbonate. So the percent purity of the calcium carbonate, which is the mass of the calcium carbonate inside the shell divided by the mass of the whole shell converted to a percentage. The calcium carbonate part of the shell is 0.4 grams. The whole shell, 0.5 grams, convert that to a percentage, 80%. 80% of this shell is made of calcium carbonate, 20% of impurities. Let's now answer a bit of a more challenging question. Shell 2 has a mass of 0.6 grams. Then we grind it up into powder. Why? So that we can react it with some hydrochloric acid. The calcium carbonate inside the ground up shell reacts with the hydrochloric acid to form calcium chloride, carbon dioxide, and water. And from this reaction, we collect 0.1 decimeters cubed of carbon dioxide at STP. And now we are asked, what is the percent purity of shell 2? First of all, it's important to understand why this question needs to be more complicated than the question for shell 1. You see, for shell 1, we were told how much of the shell was calcium carbonate. That made it very easy to find the percent purity. But in reality, how do we know what percent is calcium carbonate? We can't just know it. We have to deduce it. How do we deduce it? By doing what is described in this question. We have to grind up the shell into powder. Then we have to react that powder with an acid, for example, hydrochloric acid. Now, the important thing is the pure part of the shell, the calcium carbonate part, that is, does react with the hydrochloric acid. But the impure part, the part that is not calcium carbonate, it's there, but it does not react with the hydrochloric acid. So the amount of carbon dioxide product formed tells us how much calcium carbonate there was, which then makes the question easy again. Because then we know what mass of the shell is actually calcium carbonate. And then it's easy to get the percent purity. So to help you to understand what we're going to do, answer these questions, pause the movie while you do so, and then we'll continue together. First of all, what are we asked to calculate? The percent purity of the shell. In other words, the percent purity of calcium carbonate in the shell. And how do we calculate that? It's the mass, in grams, of calcium carbonate inside the shell divided by the mass of the shell itself, converted to a percent. So what are we missing so that we can do this calculation? Well, we already know the mass of the shell. This is not missing. That's 0.6 grams. The information that is missing is this: the mass of the calcium carbonate inside the shell. How can we find this missing value? Well, we know how much carbon dioxide is produced. There it is. And so we can find out, we can calculate the mass of calcium carbonate which must have produced that amount of carbon dioxide. So we need to find out What mass of calcium carbonate reacted to produce 0.1 decimeter cubed of carbon dioxide? And that's the mass of calcium carbonate, which we can then use to calculate the percent purity. So we first need to know the mole ratio in which the reaction occurs. Now we can actually be lazy because all that we're really interested in is calcium carbonate and carbon dioxide. Why? Because carbon dioxide is given information and we need to know the mass of calcium carbonate that is actually in the shell so that we can get its percent purity. So we can forget about the other chemicals here. So the mole ratio is very easy. 1 mole calcium carbonate is to 1 mole carbon dioxide. Now the required information is the mass of calcium carbonate and the given information is the volume of carbon dioxide. Be careful, don't give the actual values here. You mustn't go and write 0.1 decimeter cubed here. Why? Because here we are speaking about ratios. All of this here is reacting ratios, not the actual amount we have, but the ratio in which they always react. 1 mole of calcium carbonate, what is its mass? We need to know the molar mass of calcium carbonate for that. 40 grams per mole for calcium, 12 for carbon, 3 times 16 for oxygen. 100 grams per mole. So 1 mole has a mass of 100 grams. This is at STP, and 1 mole of carbon dioxide, or any gas, has a volume of 22.4 decimeters cubed. So these are our reacting ratios. Now let's get to the actual example. We are asked what mass of calcium carbonate reacted to produce 0.1 decimeters cubed of carbon dioxide. So this is the right place now to give the actual numbers for this particular example, not just the reaction ratio. To solve this, we must multiply our question by a reaction ratio, a conversion factor, which refers to how these chemicals always react, in what ratio they always react, making sure that decimeter cubed of carbon dioxide is at the bottom and grams of calcium carbonate is at the top. And we know that 100 grams of calcium carbonate would yield 22.4 decimeter cubed of carbon dioxide. Therefore, 0.1 decimeter cubed of carbon dioxide needed 0.446, and round it off to 4.5, but don't clear your calculator. Keep that value on your calculator. Grams of calcium carbonate. So what does this mean? This means the shell, which has a mass, a total mass of 0.6 grams, consists of 0.45 grams calcium carbonate and the rest is impurities. And we are asked what percentage of the shell is calcium carbonate, not impurities. So the percent purity is the mass of the calcium carbonate inside the shell, which is 0.45 grams of it, divided by the mass of the whole shell, 0.6 grams, converted to a percentage. So we use the value that is on our calculator rather than 0.45, but the full value is 0.44642851. So good practice not to clear your calculator. Divided by 0.6, 0.744 multiplied by 100%, 74.4%. 74.4% of the shell is calcium carbonate. The remaining 25.6% is impurities.